What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and we got to talk about why Old Town Road took over to the extent that it did. Because I know a lot of people understand that you might have a hit, somebody could be trolling a little bit, and then it goes viral, and he even has some influence to push the song as well. But it's so much more than that when it comes to this story. Let's hop into it. So first and foremost, after you consider the fact that yes, he did use influencers to give the song a boost in terms of visibility, you gotta give it the props that the song is just dope in the first place. It's not the only song that uses hip hop and country. There's so many different songs like that. You got people like Fly Rich Double, who has Yup on My Tractor.
I just got some new boots and a new tractor. Got it on my tractor, ran right past her. Fucked her in the pasture, yep. Tractor.
Of course, you got a lot of country artists that are rapping now. There's so many variations. So that is a part of the narrative and it's relevant, but it's still a weak narrative. It's not enough to take it to the standpoint that it did. The fact that this song was good enough to get it to the point that it was charting is actually what allowed the second narrative to come in that was far more powerful. And that was the fact that Billboard took it off of their charts. People underestimate how much this blew the song up to a whole nother level. It was already a viral hit. We have a lot of viral hits that, you know, they chart or they just get a lot of views. They might not be officially registered, but they get a lot of views, millions of views. But the fact that Billboard took it off the charts actually gave it even more traction. If they didn't really say that much about it, this song would have still been successful, but it never would have touched the level of visibility and awareness that it did. Because a lot of people were like, wait, what song got taken off the country charts? And then it created a whole other debate. Why did it get off the charts? And now you got people who are talking about it who never would have known about it. Whether it's somebody like Sway or Charlamagne Tha God on those kind of shows, Hot 97, all these radio shows. So it went from something that the youth community knew about to something that the culture of hip hop and country at large now had to consider and debate about. So if narrative being the number one reason, controversy is a very close number two because they're tied into this scenario. Now look, I'm gonna put y'all on some game right here. Don't say I ain't never told you nothing. We're in an era that a lot of people look at trolling and controversy as a method where they really can boost their visibility and careers, right? We know that that's one of the things that's considered in the Lil Pump land. But one of the biggest things that people sleep on is the fact that you don't have to beef just to create controversy. As a matter of fact, that's a lower form of controversy. It doesn't take too much thought. Yeah, let's start a fight with people who have some visibility and now we bring some attention. That's cool. We know that it does work to the extent that it does. The effects that that actually has on an artist's brand doesn't work for the type of brand that every single artist is trying to build. So what I love so much about this form of controversy right here is people are debating whether the song is hip hop or country, which causes them to actually have to listen to the music to even debate. But now seriously though, things like that still are highly beneficial in the same way that Blueface rapping off beat made people have to actually listen to the song so they can laugh at him rapping off beat or just hear what everybody else is talking about. Number three, this song has a chorus that resonates. Now I know we know how important choruses are in just making hit songs, and what people sleep on is just the fact that this is a very simple chorus, but it's one of those things that's like a battle cry, right? It's one of those things where you got pride. Can't nobody tell me nothing. Same thing like Kanye was saying, can't tell me nothing. It's that same feeling when you're just in a good vibe, right? You can imagine people in the club or at a party when they're in their zone and they feel really good about themselves, or you win a football game or you win on the video game. It's a victory cry that just transcends into so many other aspects of life. And last but not least, we've touched on this a little bit, but unique pairings. And what do I mean by unique pairings? Well, first of all, if you haven't seen my video on unique pairings, check the description below. I will put a link in there. But for those of you who have seen that video before and you're familiar with the idea of two contradicting concepts creating polarization, that's one of the primary things that play into this when we talk about why it created so much energy and so much conversation out there. Right? It's hip hop and it's country, or which one is it? I know I talked about the debate before, but what's so important to realize is when I originally did the video on unique pairings, it was just talking about how you do this for your brand, how you can make yourself a polarizing figure that stands out using contradictory ideas. But you can also do that with a project, you can do that with a singular song, and artwork, so many other aspects of life, business, whatever you're working on. And to leverage this most, you have to use the context of the time period. There's gonna be a time where you're doing a combination of hip hop and country doesn't really bring you any attention. People will be normalized to that. Country songs that have rap in them is already a normal thing that doesn't really get you too much extra attention. But a lot of this rap driven music that has a little country play on in it and style in it, like this Lil Nas X song, that got people's attention. The novelty will wear off soon. What's beneficial is that is actually a good song. But something that everybody can think about is, what are some areas that you can utilize this concept? Remember that innovation is not necessarily creating new things from scratch. That's inventing. But innovation is taking previous things and putting them together in new ways. You can be an innovator, find those categories, connect those new dots. Other than that, I would love to know what you guys think about what made this hit additionally. Like, what is something that I didn't mention, or just what's something you noticed about this track and the rise of Lil Nas X? Other than that, if you like this video, go ahead, hit the like button. If you like it, might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe.